Hi everyone, this is R.V. Kiran, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Chebrol Engineering College. Today I am going to deliver a topic of advanced materials, and the topic is ceramic matrix composites. And this is my fourth lecture in the concept of advanced materials. In the previous lectures we have already discussed about the different classification of composites. That is, first one is the basic classification, depends on the type of reinforcements, that is particle sized and fiber reinforced and structural. And in the second type of classification, there are polymer matrix composites, metal matrix composites and ceramic matrix composites. In the previous lecture, we have seen about the polymer matrix composites and metal matrix composites. Now, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the last one, that is ceramic matrix composites. So, this is the classification based on the matrices type. So, there are two types of classification in the composites. First one is the classification based on reinforcement type, and second one is the classification based on the matrices type. So matrix is the singular form, matrices is the plural form we are using on the composites based. So in this classification, the matrices are divided into three types. First one is the polymer matrix composite, second one is the metal matrix composite, and third one is the ceramic matrix composites. And polymer matrix can be divided into three types: thermosets, thermoplastics and rubber. We have already seen in the last lecture. Metal matrix composites also we have seen in the previous lecture. And last one is the ceramic matrix composites. So what are these ceramic matrix composites? So ceramic matrix composites are materials in which one or more ceramic phases are intentionally added to other. So in order to deliver or extract some properties from the two different distinct materials, we are combining these ceramic, two different ceramic matrix composites. So these ceramic matrix composites are designated as fibers or types of matrix. So these are divided based upon the fibers and matrix type. So in the previous lecture we have discussed about the matrix type and polymers type. In this we are going to discuss about the type of fiber type. So there is glass fiber, aramid fiber, so different types of fibers are there. So in that, based on the size also, there are short fibers and long fibers, chopped fibers, fillers. So these are the different types of fibers available in the ceramic matrix composites. And type of matrix also we are going to discuss. So these basic examples are carbon-carbon composites, carbon-silicon-carbide composites, and next silicon-carbide-silicon carbide, and last one is the aluminium oxide. So these are the basic examples of the ceramic matrix composites. Next we have seen a picture on the bottom of this slide. So the matrix here used is silicon carbide, and the fiber used are the carbon fiber. And the types of solid are amorphous, semi-crystalline and crystalline. We are using here is amorphous carbon matrix. So the basic material in the ceramic matrix composites used here are silicon carbide matrix, and the fiber used are the carbon fiber. So we are seeing the sticks like structures here, that is the carbon fillers used as the reinforcement. And types of solid are amorphous carbon matrix, and the basic matrix is silicon carbide. So these are the basic material of the silicon carbide matrix. So next slide is upon the why we are using the ceramic matrix composites. So what is the purpose of using and what is the benefits we have using ceramic matrix composites over the other composites, that is polymer matrix composites or metal matrix composites. So we have, you are seeing the difference here with metal matrix composites. So in the metals, the obtained properties are high fracture toughness, good tensile strength and good machinability and good formability of the basic structure. So the molecules are arranged in a continuous manner, so continuous and aligned manner. But in the ceramics, the properties are, it obtains good hardness, good thermal resistance, good electrical resistance, good corrosion resistance and refractoriness. Refractoriness means when we use the component or material in the second time and third time also, that is in the purpose of recycling also, the properties obtained in the material do not erase in the material. So it will be there in the as original properties only. So that is the pure benefit of ceramic matrix composites over metal matrix composites. So corrosion resistance also, it is a good property over metal matrix composites, and it has good thermal resistance and good electrical resistance also. So to overcome the problem associated with the ceramics, so when we use the pure ceramics, no matrix or no composite form, only pure ceramics when we are used, the elongation rupture is up to 1%, but it will be more than in the metal matrix composites. It also increases the fracture toughness also. So when the load is applied on the material, the bearing load or yield stress would be greater. So if the yield stress will be less, small or less than the fracture toughness, it will be automatically failure, leads to the failure. So third one is the extreme thermal shock resistance. So these all the applied by the shutdown loads or impact loads. Fourth one is the improved dynamic load capability. And last one is the anisotropic properties following the orientation of fibers. So in the orientation of fibers, when we are using the reinforcement, so when we are using the, or when we are developing the reinforcement in the matrix, the properties available or dislocate the properties are anisotropic properties. So these anisotropic properties continues the orientation of fibers, that is short fiber or long fiber. So in this, size of the property of fiber or behavior of the fiber depends upon the alignment and orientation. So that is continuously aligned or randomly oriented. So next one is the toughening mechanisms. So when we have applied the loads on the material, the mechanism or the mechanism developed in the integral part of the material is known as the toughening mechanisms. So in the first peak, we have seen about the crack encountered in the fiber when it gets deflected. So the crack getting deflected by the fibers, so that is known as osteons. So when the long fibers are used and the load is applied on the fiber, the crack gets deflected. But in the second picture, that is collision fibers here used, so the crack will enlarged. So energy absorbed by the pull out and crack bridging is done in the second picture. So here we are seeing the two different types of mechanisms. One is the deviated way, one is the absorbed way. So first one is the deviated or deflected way, second one is the bridging way. Bridging means continuous behavior of the load or property on the material, that is here, that is the crack here. But in the first picture, the load or the impact on the material gets diverted or deflected. Next one is the manufacturing of CMC, ceramic matrix composites. So here we are using the fibers in the manufacturing of ceramic matrix composites. So first one is the fiber manufacturing. So directly the manufacturing name also should be fiber manufacturing. Second one is the layup of fibers, that is preforming of the fibers. And third one, in that second step is the fibers or fillers or whiskers will be laid in the shape as the desired components. So using by the reinforcement we can form also the desired shape observed in the matrix, and the fibers are aligned in the way it is in the form of lamina. So we already discussed about these structural composites, that is laminas or sandwich panels. So in that the laminas are in the form of layups. Layups means layer by layer it is forming the fiber sections. So that is one is the second one. And third one is the infiltration of matrix material. So infiltration means not filtering the pure material. So we are using the reinforcements here, we are not using the pure material. So these infiltration is done in the matrix material. So matrix material we are using up to 80 to 85%, and 10 to 15% we are using the reinforcements such as fibers, that is long or short or chopped or fillers. And last one is the secondary process, finish requirement, functionality and aesthetics. Aesthetics means the covering part of the material, that is powder coating. And functionality is the impregnation of intrinsic porosity for lubrication. So lubrication purpose. And finishing requirement is the grinding property, so or grinding section. So when we use the surface finish in the operation of grinding, we use the finish requirement. Next one is the applications of ceramic matrix composites. Where are we using these ceramic matrix composites? It is continuously and relevantly using in the space vehicles and heat shield systems. So heat shield systems is the interior core part of the space vehicles, that is used as in the ceramic matrix composites. Second one is the sliding bearings under heavy loads. So this is the picture of the sliding bearings under heavy loads. And third one is the disc brakes. So nowadays disc brakes are known to everyone. So we are using in the two wheeler, four wheeler and heavy trucks also. These disc brakes are also used by the ceramic matrix composites. And what are the advantages of the ceramic matrix composites? So the basic advantage is the high hardness and high stiffness over the metal matrix composites. So comparing to the polymer matrix composites, they are very high in the property segment. So we are not considering with the polymer matrix composite, we are considering with the metal matrix composites only. So it also contains low density. So ceramic matrix composites are very light in weight structure, and these are resistant to wear and corrosion. Wear ante అరిగిపోవటం. సో మనం యూజ్ చేసే కొద్ది ఒక మెటీరియల్ ఒక సర్ఫేస్ అనేది, అవుటర్ సర్ఫేస్ అనేది అరిగిపోతూ ఉంటుంది. సో రబ్ అయిపోతూ ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి దాన్ని వేర్ అంటున్నాం. నెక్స్ట్ అండ్ కరోజన్. కరోజన్ మీన్స్ తుప్పు పడటం. సో నెక్స్ట్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఇస్ ద కెమికల్లీ స్టేబుల్ ఇన్ వైడ్ రేంజ్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంటల్ కండిషన్స్ అండ్ టెంపరేచర్స్. నెక్స్ట్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ ది డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంటల్ కండిషన్స్ అండ్ temperature. So in the last slide we are seen about the space vehicles. So here the environmental temperature is, or room temperature is up to 30 to 35 degrees centigrade, but in the space it varies. So the temperature increases or decreases from this room temperature. So according to the range of environmental conditions, we use it to change the stability of the material. So next one is the optical transparency over a wide range of wavelengths. So we are using a different wavelengths here, Next, electrical resistance and high toughness. So electrical resistance also a good property, and last one is the high toughness. So these high toughness are very higher than the pure ceramic compounds. So when we use the pure ceramic compounds, there are not much toughness compared to the metal matrix composites, but regarding to the ceramic matrix composites, it is higher high toughness than the ceramics metal matrix composites compared to ceramics. The next one is the disadvantages. So there are limited number of disadvantages for the ceramic matrix composites. So the all disadvantages are in the health hazard issues only. So these National Cancer Institute have indicated that fibers have a diameter of 1 micrometer, and these carcinogenic when introduced to lining, the lung will be damaged in some integration. So due to the smoke of the material or pollution of the material, the lung would be somewhat damaged. Next one is the commercial available aluminum silicate fibers have developed increased number of lung cancer in animals exposed to it. So animals also have some disadvantage with the ceramic matrix composite with the pollution or with the smoke of it. And last one is the no doubt available for humans, but study suggest to consider it carcinogenic until data become available. So some research have been going there. So there are no direct disadvantage to the humans, but it has some disadvantage to our health hazard issues to the animals, that is rats or some other animals. So this is the disadvantage of the ceramic matrix composites, and by here I am ending this topic. Thank you.